I guess, yeah. That's why I'm not with nobody, cause I don't wanna hurt nobody. Did it over text, didn't call me. Still got love for your mommy. I know you wanna be somebody, even if you gotta leave somebody. Yes, I'm hurt, yes, I'm dead. Most of the things I don't wanna say.
Literally, this like whole experience has just been a roller coaster.
Yeah. It is currently 7:20. If you can't tell, I'm sure I can get my life together. But today I have my first big girl interview. Like, I didn't have like a big girl job, but like this is a big girl job. Like, I have to dress up, heels, business attire. I'm like so nervous. You can like, I know that I'm like really nervous and my anxiety is terrible. Also, my stomach has been hurting since yesterday. My anxiety is so bad. Like, is that kind of big girl job? I'm like excited, but I'm like so nervous at the same time. I probably won't even post this vlog if I don't get the job. And I'm also not gonna like say the job right now until after, just in case I don't get it, maybe if I still need the vlog. It's like, no, like I'm literally just gonna delete this and forget that it happened if I don't get it. But I know that I am going to get it, period. Gotta speak stuff into existence. Anyway, the interview is 2 hours away. So that's why I'm up so dang early. Because I have to drive there. Well, my sister and my cousin are gonna go with me, but they're like, it's like a hiring event, so they're gonna drop me off and then they're gonna go and do whatever they can do in those hours. They were saying something about brunch, so they're gonna have the time of their life today while I'm stressing at a little hiring event. Anxiety through the roof. They're gonna be somewhere drinking mimosas, having a good time. Hope they drink one for me. So yeah, it doesn't start until, it does not start until 1 o'clock. Like, they asked us to be there at 1 o'clock. It actually starts at 1:30, but they asked us to be there like in line at 1 o'clock because this is an event with over like 40 people trying to like apply at the same time. So they asked us to be there like early, just checking in and everything. So I'm one of those people that if you're on time, you're late. So I really wanted to be there by like 12:30. Like I said, it's like 2.5 hours away. So I would go like 7 to hopefully be ready by like 8:30, 9 o'clock, leave the house by, you know, like 9:15. That'll give us plenty of time for traffic or if we need to stop, if, you know, anything. Like, it gives me plenty of time. For, you know, you have to think of the unthinkable sometimes when you're traveling places. And also, I'm like one of those people that's like, I told you my anxiety is bad, so I do not want nothing to happen and I'm late or I miss or anything like that. Like, I'm one of those people. So yeah, I'm about to try to get my life anyway. I could not sleep half of the day all night. Like, that's my problem. Like, I'm so tired because, well, part of the time is because I came home yesterday from work and took a nap about 4 hours. And then this time of the day, I was asleep. I was all that tired. And then, you know, I was like, you know, the night before the first day of school, that's what it felt like. Like, you just fell asleep. Just, like, I don't know. Yeah. My sister said that if you don't floss your teeth, you don't wash your butt crack. She's insane, isn't she? I know. But she said, if you're not willing to, get in your teeth and make sure they're clean, really in your teeth, then you're not doing the same thing with your butt. Insane. My sister did my hair last night, so I really don't have to wear my hair, but I do have to do my makeup. And I like doing makeup before I get dressed, but I'm so scared because I don't want to mess up my dress when I put my makeup on. But then if I do have the dress on with the makeup, that's more I can more mess it up. So I'm just going to do it and then put bag on my head. I took a shower. So. Yeah, I literally got two scarves because I was afraid that this one was gonna slide back, so I had this one to help me tie it. Help me tie it down. But I need to. So a little bit. So, you want to do. Yeah, probably me out for you.
Oh my god.
Yeah, what is she up laughing at 7:30 in the morning?
Yeah. So, I'm trying to decide if I'm going to wear lashes or not, because mine look hot time, but I don't want it to look like dramatic makeup. Like I told y'all, this is like a businessy, like really big girl interview, so I'm not trying to give going out, if you don't know what I'm trying to say, then oh the heck well. But yeah, I love this primer. So yeah, love it. Get it right from Walmart or Target, honey. Most of my products that I get are from Target. I have not gotten to that big girl level where I'm wearing Ulta and Sephora brands, which they probably do have this at Ulta and Sephora, but you can get it right from Walmeezy, Foshizy. But at first, I really didn't like it, and I was like, why do I not like, because my cousin had told me to get this, and I'm like, I trust her, so what's going on with it? But I don't know if I wasn't getting enough time to set to my skin. Maybe I was putting too much lotion or something on before it. I really don't know, but I didn't like it at first. But now she's that girl. But I want to switch and get the Grip primer. You know what I'm talking about, because a lot of people say that works very well.
you know. I also seen this girl on the talk. When she put her primer on, she sprayed like just like light mist of setting spray on top, let it dry, and then did it. And then she like would put setting spray like in between her steps of makeup, and it worked out very well. So I've been doing that as well. And you just need a light layer. Oh. A light layer, like I was saying. Since I'm just doing like light, I'm just putting some like some concealer under here, because if you can't tell, my eyes are got bags, so you know they won't sleep. Then once again, same girl, this girl, we love her. Put some of this. We're going for a very much light coverage today, not too much, just enough. So, using this Real Techniques brush, put a little bit more on here. Yeah, I'm really not one of them people for tutorials, like, just watch what I do. Like, it works for me. So it's like, I can't really tell you everything that I did, but just watching, you'll see, right? Yeah, period. I like to do like this. Make sure you get under that chin, honey. And like, spread. I'm not even doing my eyebrows today, y'all, because like I said, natural, little, nice and soft beat. And also, it takes me so long to do my eyebrows. And I have time, but ain't gonna have time for that. You know what I'm saying? So once I feel like this is at a good spot, take it. If you do the eyelids, so especially since I'm not doing my eyebrows and I won't be blending nothing else on, I'm just not doing eyeshadow, nothing like that. Look at that. I'm gonna take my raunchy. This is also Real Techniques. I need to get a new one for real. Take a little setting spray. And blend your concealer out. I use the other end. It's not. Do a little tap. You don't need so much. Sometimes I even do like one of those. Just like that. We want our bake and shake. Oh. Ew. Yeah, I really don't know if I want to put my lash on or not. Yeah, well, I guess I answered my undergone question about if I was going to wear lashes or not. The answer is no, because I don't even know where they are. I don't even know. Like, I literally looked everywhere. I had... I had lashes when I did my little like pendant thing last week. I took them with me because I didn't have enough time to put them on. So I'm like, you know, I just put them on when I get there or in the car or something. And then I lost folks in the car and didn't put them on in the car. And I just can't remember where I put them. My nose was looking up. I can't remember where I put them. Like. At all whatsoever, like I don't know. And then I have, oh. I have these old behind little caterpillars that I have. Like they'll work for something on my eyes, but I don't think I want to put them on. Like, literally, a little caterpillar. It's always something. All right. Lordy mercy. Lordy. I might end up doing this whole dip my lip and deciding that I hate it, so. Because, yeah, I don't know. Because sometimes when I put the red on, it just, you know what, I'm not even going to waste my time. I'm just going to do it. Nope. One more thing. I'm going to do some. Yeah, I don't got no blush, okay? So, don't talk about what I have to do. It's a little bit dumb, but it works, okay? I'm gonna be just like a little resourceful. Okay? Period. I'll use this one for that, but I need something. Here's that. Yes. This is pink lipstick. And I just did your mama. Took a little. Not a lot. Cause it. A lot. Put a little bit like that, right? Stay with me, stay with me. Then, I'm gonna use that. Take some eyeshadow. And here's a little boop. Like a circular upwards. Take some more. Don't worry. I trust the process here. Yep. Then you take same brushes for your foundation and blend it in a little. You do not want to be looking. Even though you don't be looking like no dang old clown. You just want it to be a little visible. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, perfect. Now, I'm not going to use a lot of highlight. Just enough to do a little dasher. Yeah. Yep. Okay. Yes, and I do have a brush, but I told you I wasn't trying to do a lot. Do one of those numbers. No, I am about to use my brush for this part because I can never get to. Period. I know that when I do my makeup, it's like A to D. I just be all over the place, but it works. It works for me. This, y'all, is by Fenty. That girl Riri. We love her. But look at the. Let me back it up so you can see. Look, like the color red is so. Red, like, and it's good, like, it's good coverage, but I'm telling you, if you put too much, it will just be everywhere, like, on your teeth, everything, like, you literally have to, like, like, y'all, this is how it looks after just a couple dabs, like, it's easier to just put a little and spread it versus putting a lot and it'll get everywhere. Like, and then I got these little behind lips. A little in the corner. I see, look, it already like. So I have to like try to. I'll use a little. Tell y'all every time. I know I'm gonna be sweating today. Okay. Let me clean this mess up. Then we'll get. I'm gonna clean this mess up. And then we'll go in my room. Cause it's time to get dressed. I've not found a good place in my room yet where I can get dressed and y'all can see like everything. Because I have so much room. I mean, so much stuff in my room with so little space. Like, I have that whole corner over there with, like, all my business stuff. And this in front of me is, like, my dresser. And my bed is huge. So there's literally, like, no extra, like, wall space. Like, I don't know. I really don't know what I'm going to do about that. We'll figure it out. Alright. First of all, y'all. Okay, I had to make sure I had a pearl necklace. Because we need her. Ooh. I got two. I think I'm going to do the bigger one. Shoot. Wait, this. Oh, here we go. Wait. Yeah, the big one's good. I'll put them both. Got one little bracelet. That's okay. We don't need a whole bunch. Y'all. Like, I ain't gonna say that I never wore pantyhose before because I have. But, like, not at my big age. Like, I usually. Like, the last time I wore pantyhose was probably, like, as like a little kid to, like, church or something. I don't know. Something. So when I was trying to find them, kind of got them right from Walmeezy for Sheezy. When I was trying to find them, I'm like, what the heck? Why is there so many kinds? Kind of see-through, opaque. What the heck? Like, Which the kind I got is super opaque. They had kind of opaque. Like, the heck? I think I'll just be able to go in there, get the black with a little taste of see through, and go about my business. Where's the back? Oh, here we go. But Walmart had a plan. So. These come all the way up. They're like high waist or something. So, like, oh. Control top, honey. I don't even need no control top, but got that control top, honey. This is a dress, honey. Real bad. Calvin Klein. It's like, yeah, I know it's Calvin Klein. I just want to say that. Calvin Klein. Like, it's like a little set. Like, this is what the dress looks like by itself. Real grown, honey. And this is like a little blazer. Try to get something thin. We got her right from Ross. And, when I was trying to get a dress, I'm like, where am I gonna find a business dress? Cause the store I shop said don't have that. Like, they do not have those kind of dresses. So I was like, Ross. I was like, Ross or Boscons. I knew exactly where to get a little, I call it old lady church dress. Okay. Everything ready, honey. So I don't have to have this bag on top of my head for too long. I'm trying to circle feet before the interview. And this just got a little. Oops. It got slit, y'all. I'm too wrong with the slit, honey. But I need to make sure that. Alright. Here we go. Rip me out the plastic, honey. Rip me out the plastic. I'll be back. I'm doing another pure. And usually, you know, like, the dress is actually like really cute by itself, but I just feel like extra businessy, extra wrong if I put the little thing on top. Plus, I don't know if it's like the, like, if it's gonna be like cold in the place. So, ooh, take that tag. I zip this thing by myself. I gotta try to get this clipped. Ooh, I think I got it. Thing is, y'all, after I wear this dress today, I'm probably gonna be taking it back to like a Goodwill or something, because I'm never gonna wear this. And I need scissors, hold on. Mm-hmm. Like, it really like just hides it, makes it look, make me look a little buff up here, but that's okay. This is the, I'm gonna be standing up on this bed in a minute to show y'all. I'll just show y'all, like, in the bathroom. My goodness. Yo, look, I can't even, like, I really look like corporate baby. Alright. And these are my shoes I'm wearing. I didn't have them stretching for the toes because my toes are so bad, y'all. Well, the one toe, I should say, because I had surgery on it. So, like, trying to bend it and make it squish into, like, a two, like, like a too small shoe or like a really tight shoe is a no-go, and I'd be crying out in pain. So my sister's feet are a little bit wider than mine, so I had her put them on and like blow dried them with her, while they were on her feet, so they could stretch at the top. Then I did the same thing so they could kind of stretch to my foot, like fit to my foot. So yeah. I feel like I wanted it to, no, it's fine, I guess. I thought I wanted it to hang a little bit more, but it's okay. Perfume Eau de Lait YSL, because grown, like I said, I need to smell grown. Like, I was like looking at some like suggestions, like things that you should like wear when you're like going to this interview, and they said to wear a watch. Yeah, but the only watch I have is my Apple Watch. Like, I don't have watches, I only have my Apple Watch. And people be like, stop wearing them Apple Watches when you dressed up looking like Spy Kids. So I don't know if I should wear it. Like, I literally don't know what I should do, because then like the only, I maybe for my black band, but I really have a cute, like a, you know, like a wristwatch type band. Like, it literally is gonna look like a Apple Watch band. So maybe I should just, I'm just gonna leave it alone, I guess. Yeah, I feel like I'm really good old church lady, but okay, not so bad. We can take that off. I'm gonna show y'all the whole completed fit. Shoes on. Decided to go no lashes, by the way. It's the bag. To leave, I might vlog some of the drive. I don't know yet. I might. So, but I am about to leave. I can't vlog any there. So, like, literally the drive probably, and then, like, after. I'll let y'all know what happens. Wish me luck, even though y'all may or may not see this even after the hour to be over. But,
vlog. I made it to the hotel. Y'all said I'm not gonna post this vlog if I don't get the job. But I'm still gonna vlog it because I believe I'm gonna get it. So I'm still gonna vlog. I'm really giving somebody's grown ass mom. Like, she's like on the camera like a mom. Yeah. Coming to pick up Judah from school. Look at her. Child, a child. Why do you got your feet? It's the feet up for me. We got here too early. So I'm just waiting in the car out front, so they can take my car, because who's gonna do all that parking and stuff, and they're gonna leave it anyway. So just waiting out front, hoping nobody make us move. Oh, my lashes are just a hot time.
I got the job. But when I say that, this has been the most draining day. I mean, like, the interview process was long. Long. Like, so long. Like, it's ridiculous. And, like, they don't really want us to, like, do too much talking about it, so I won't. But it was a group interview, and it, like, one-on-one interview. Plus, like, if you made it past all of that, fingerprinting and drug testing. I mean, like, it was a very long, exciting, long day. And I had to drive. Well, I didn't really. I drove there. My sister drove back. Well, my cousin drove back. And yeah. So it's like almost 12 o'clock right now. We literally just got back, but honey, I was not waiting no longer to get in this bathroom and get in the shower so I could go to bed, because I actually have work tomorrow at school. So I'm tying my hair because, baby, I'm keeping this bun right for work tomorrow. I got time for nothing. Actually, I'm so tired. So, like, seriously, I've been up since 7 o'clock, so I'm tired. But I'm, like, so excited for this journey, and I get to take y'all with me. Oh my god, it's gonna be such a fun, but, like, stressful and, you know, learning opportunity. So I didn't post anything about the interview process because they literally were interviewing the whole time. So, like, you did not want to be on your phone, like, seem uninterested at all. Like, although there were, like, group activities and stuff, you know, you really wanted to seem like, you know, and with the everything, you know, I'm trying to say, shoot, I'm tired. So yeah, I am about to have, like, this next, like, 6 months of my life is about to be very interesting, and y'all get to come with me. So thank y'all, love y'all, see y'all next time. I probably look our best like somebody's mama. I don't even care, like, that's the thing, like, I get on this camera and I don't even care. But anyway, bye y'all. Hey guys, I haven't talked to y'all in a long time, like a month now. It's been since I made a video, which is crazy, but we're all gonna find out soon. Well, y'all, why can't I talk? Y'all are gonna find out soon why I haven't been, like, making videos and stuff. It is currently like 8 o'clock, and I am getting ready to get in the shower and go find some pants, and y'all just gonna spend my last day at home with me. I'm leaving home for work. I am not disclosing what that work is yet, but I have to leave home for that work. And I have to go away for 4 weeks for that work. So today's my last day at home. I'm leaving today, and today is August 27th, and I'm not going to be back home until September 22nd. So, like, about a month. This, like, whole journey for sure, like, the past month has definitely been, like, bittersweet and emotional, but I'm here, and, like, I'm excited for this new journey, and I get to take y'all with me. I can't wait till y'all, like, find out what it is. Like, I mean, some people already know. Like, I've told, like, family, like, my old coworkers and things like that, because they were, like, asking if I was coming back and stuff. So I pretty much have told them what's going on. But I'm pretty much keeping it a secret from everybody else. Like, I just wanna pop out with it, like, surprise. Also, this job requires training, and, like, if you don't get through that training, like, then you don't get, you know? So it's like, that's another reason why, like, when you go to take your license test, don't tell everybody you're going to take your license test, because then if you fail, everybody knows you failed your license test. It's like similar to that. Yeah. Although I don't, like, I have very high hopes for myself, and also, like, no negativity. Like, I'm already going into it with a positive attitude that I'm coming back home with the job. Absolutely. Like, I'm going to pass this training and get through it. It's going to be super, super hard. But, yeah. Yeah, so today's vlog is going to be, like, probably sad, honestly. Like, probably one of my most non-lit vlogs. Because last night, like, we got lit, remember? I had, like, a dinner, going away dinner, and we got lit. So today is kind of like, and I told everybody, like, no sadness yesterday. Like, none at all. I don't want to be sad. Like, I just want to save all my tears and sadness for Sunday when I leave. Because, And, yeah. I don't know. Like, my nerves are everywhere. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I can't even tell y'all how I'm feeling right now. I'm, like, excited, nervous. Like, I'm literally going to the 5 stages of grief right now. Like, literally, I've experienced so many emotions in just, like, the last couple hours. Literally, like, I don't know, y'all. But, yeah. Not gonna just probably be much talking in the video today. I'm just gonna take y'all with me. And we're just gonna see what I get into today and how much I cried today. Yeah, so I'm gonna take a shower and get dressed, and then I will be back. I'll be sure. Alright, y'all, so I just threw this out the letter to stores because I need to find, like, a couple more things before I leave. So we have to dress like business casual before we try it on. So I just feel like I need to, like, one more pair of pants. And I'm just so last minute. I have to be gone by 2:30. Really, I need to be gone a little bit before 2:30. Because it's been not even giving me time for, like, traffic and shit, but. You know, black people. Cry count one. I cried in the shower, y'all. Like, I don't know. It's like everything started to just, I don't know. Like, in the shower sometimes, like, I really, like, that's my thinking time. So, I was really, like, my brain really, like, goes like that in the shower. So, that's probably why I cried in the shower. Because I was, like, actually, that was, like, my first time being cool. Like, completely quiet and actually thinking about what the fuck was about to happen today. Like, I don't know, like, you know, like, days like this, it still seems, like, surreal. Like, when, like, events like this happen, they just seem surreal until I'm actually in it. Like, to be honest, I probably won't have real tears until I walk through TSA at the airport today. Like, for real.
I'm not gonna lie, training and exams and things like that started right away, and they told us, like, on the first day we couldn't really record or take pictures of anything during training, so you guys won't see much, but you'll see some things. Like, here I had to learn how to use a freaking steamer. Like, at my big age, it was my first time using a steamer. I've only ever used irons, but they did not have irons, y'all. I was struggling, but it turned out good, and by week 2 I was doing that thing no problem.
I have not even had a chance to even come on here and talk to y'all. It's day 2 of training. Day 2 is complete, actually. But we have an exam tomorrow, our first exam. If you couldn't tell, I already ate dinner. I mean, it's not while we study, because we're currently studying for exam, me and my roommate. But we're taking a break. She went inside to get her jacket. And I'm outside eating. So far, so good. I'm kind of nervous for this exam, but at the same time, manifestation is everything. So I just keep like, I'm gonna pass. Because we have to get 90% or higher. You do get like a retake, but like, I'm not trying to get a retake. Like, you know, I'm just trying to pass my exam, going about my business. Because you don't get 2 retakes, like of the whole thing, the whole training. I don't know. I can't really tell you guys that much information, or like record things in class, or much of anything really. That's why I really haven't been recording. So, yeah. But when y'all see me next, hopefully when y'all see me next, I will have passed my exam. I literally suck at getting content, but mainly because I've been stressed and studying, but this big behind box is my uniforms. 6 days until graduation. Oh yeah, vlogs. Since I haven't been vlogging that much, let me catch up to speed. Your girl has been passing all her exams with 95 plus. I don't have any more record exams left. My final is on Saturday. It is Thursday. Passed one. My vac drill last night. The most stressful drill of all. I have one more drill today. Oh, 2 more drills today, and then I'll be done with drills. Then I only have to make it through my final on Saturday. Then I have an IOE Sunday to Monday. Then next Thursday it'll be official. I'll be a flight attendant. I graduate next Thursday. I cannot wait. The stress, the anxiety, and I'm sorry that I'm out of breath. I did lose my train of thought. But yeah, sorry I'm out of breath, but this Wyoming altitude air, whatever you want to call it, all of the things mixed together ain't no joke. Literally walk from here to there across the parking lot, boy, have you out of breath sound, like my suit isn't a pound of life. So yeah, but 2 more days here, then we get to move.
Okay. The skirt is kind of big. I think I got the 4 because Shauna told me that she did it before. Because they didn't have a 2 to try on, they had a 4. And she's like, you're fitting in the 4 kind of good.
I tried on the 4 and I think it fit, but like, I also felt like it might have been just like the tiny bit.
I got 2 sweaters. I got the button up one and the open one. Because I wasn't 100% sure about
I might. I don't know.
I thought about it.
I mainly just, like, have been recording for, like, my YouTube.
Uh-huh.
Sky.
I don't
know
YouTube. I thought about it.
I think, what is yours? Oh, that's the apron. One dress and two dresses. And I have to figure out how to tie a tie.
No,
I wish it came with like the clip.
Yeah. Okay. We'll ask one of the guys.
And now like, hello.
Warren might know.
Oh yeah. He does. I think I've seen him wear a tie. Help me! Hey guys. So, I'm currently in Tampa, Florida right now, preparing for my flight hours tomorrow. So, I'll be going on a real flight and being a flight attendant tomorrow. I'm not, like, an employed, like, crew member yet, but, like, they require you to do flight hours before graduation. So tomorrow's mine. I'm going from Tampa to Long Island, back to Tampa, which is really nice because then I get to spend another night in Tampa. So I got here, technically I got here today at, I left 12:59 a.m. So basically like I left Saturday night. We went from Wyoming to Denver Saturday, got there. I got there around 9 o'clock, honestly, maybe like the hotel around 9, left and got to the airport around 10:30, and my flight left at like 1 a.m. really, and I got here, when I got here was like, I want to say 6 a.m. on the dot. I had to like go through a time change, so the timing is just a little, still getting me all wrapped up, but yeah. And then I checked into my hotel around 6:30. No, definitely like 7 a.m. I waited for the shuttle for at least 30 minutes. So like 7 a.m. I checked in. Then before I even got comfy, I went to Walmart because I have to get stuff like to do my hair because, you know, TSA. They basically threw away everything for my hair, but I got a trick this time. I got like travel bottles and things like that that I plan to put all my stuff in to go back to Denver. So I will go on my flight tomorrow, come back to this same hotel, spend another night, and then go to Denver early morning on Tuesday, which I'm kind of excited to like hear about everybody's experiences, be back with my classmates, so that'll be exciting. And plus I'll have like the rest of Tuesday and Wednesday to just chill, do nothing, and prepare for graduation on Thursday. I am actually so excited to graduate on Thursday. Being here, I feel like would make the like first 2 days go by faster, because I can't imagine just like being in the hotel, like, you know, getting amped up and excited, ready for graduation. But yeah, so I'm definitely super excited. I really wish that I got more content at the airport, but Denver airport was like that to me. It was a lot going on, and I was just trying to get to where I needed to be because it was like my first time there. I didn't want to be late. So, yeah, I didn't really get, but hopefully I can record a lot more content for you guys tomorrow. It'll be my first time. Well, Saturday was my first time, like, putting on a uniform, but tomorrow will be my first time putting it on to go on a flight. Like, woo! It just sounds so exciting, doesn't it? Yeah, I can't wait, honestly. So, I'm going to try to get some sleep. I think I'm going to wash my hair because crunchy, like it is crunchy because the first day I did my hair at the hotel Saturday, it was literally like, it was a struggle, I'm not gonna lie. I didn't even have a brush, so I literally had to use so much gel to like get my hair slick down. So I think I'm gonna wash it just so it's like fresh, because I really want to look nice. I really want to like have a good impression on the flight crew and my ISC and everything like that tomorrow. Like, I, you know, your first impression is your best impression. So, you really, I'm going to try to be super early and just look good. So, wish me luck. Well, I'm wishing my own self luck, because when y'all see this, I'll be graduated, have my wings. Y'all, I'm very sad because my roommate did not,
she did not get to come to Denver with me, and I'm so sad because literally me and her met at the airport on my first day of coming to Wyoming. Like, we literally went from the Denver airport. I lie because I have been in Denver airport, but like, when you're getting off the plane, it's like different. And it was like 4 weeks ago. Like, it's like they were doing construction or something. I really, whatever. So we literally went from the Denver airport to Cheyenne together. We're literally, we didn't even know we were roommates. So we got there and then we ended up being roommates and we literally clicked the first day. And I just, it doesn't even feel right continuing the journey without her. So I have been a little sad, just like, I have been like really a little bit sad. But like, things like this are definitely all part of the journey. I definitely cannot wait to like put this video all together and y'all go through the emotional roller coaster with me. It definitely has been one, but I literally, it was so worth it. It has taught me literally so much about myself, about life, just like a lot of things in general. So I'm very thankful that I did get this opportunity and that I am almost at the end, literally almost at the end. Yeah, so I'm trying to get some sleep, y'all. Wash my hair, finish eating. I'm eating. I got some pasta and some pizza because I really just wanted pasta, not gonna lie, but I guess I don't have Olive Garden. Like, Olive Garden wasn't close enough for DoorDash. So I had to get Pizza Hut and like suffice, which would be good anyway because I'm gonna eat food when I get back tomorrow and Tuesday. So hopefully this will last me a couple days. But I ate all the pasta, honey. That pasta is good. It was so good. So I'm gonna eat, shower, and get ready for tomorrow. So I will talk to y'all in the morning. Love y'all. Good morning, guys. It is 9 a.m. I've been up for like an hour now. I literally could not sleep. Like, freaking Christmas Eve, y'all. That's literally what it felt like. Christmas Eve last night, I could not sleep. But today's the day. I don't know. Like, I'm a little bit nervous. But then again, I'm like, I got this. Like, what am I nervous for? So, I'm kind of feeling good. I went and got some waffles, but like, my nerves and anxiety is not even allowing me to eat it. I'm like forcing myself to eat it because I don't want to be like hungry, and I'm not sure if I have time at the airport to get food or whatever. I'll probably like get a coffee or something at the airport. That usually helps me, just fills me up. So I don't know. My shoulders hurt so bad, like, oh, this, it just hurts so bad. I guess I had two heavy behind bags and I had to carry them on my shoulders because it wasn't a suitcase, and it is really weighing on me. Like, I'm sitting there like, dang, I can't, like, what in the world? And it's like that hurt good feeling, like when you put pressure on it, it's like, but yeah, that's it. I'm about to finish forcing myself to eat. I'm trying to eat words. I'm trying to eat like two waffles. And yeah. So I'll talk to y'all when I'm starting to get ready.
Alright, first things first, we're gonna get some tunes. Not my phone being on melatonin release music. I told you I couldn't sleep last night. I needed some type of help, maybe. If I don't have my music playing, I can't do anything. Like, it don't matter what it is. Driving, I'll wait to pull off till my music starts playing. Getting ready, I'll literally wait to start getting ready till my music starts playing. I don't know. It just really, you know, really gets me going. We're gonna tackle this head first. I wish I didn't have to roll my hair up, but I'm definitely good. Thank you.
is definitely my favorite song on the album so far. I don't know. HG4 is awesome up there. Come see me, check me. I mean, no skips usually. Rod is just superior. Now I've been freaking putting body pins. What's like the month? Yeah, I've been putting body pins everywhere, like a freaking, I don't know. Like freaking band-aids, for real. They fix everything past me. Last night we made love until the sun came. I know it's hard when I'm leaving out with you. I love you, I love you.
My view every morning, period.
It really gives Granny getting ready for church, but that's okay. For real, that's it, that's all I have. Hopefully I can get some content, like on my way there, checking in, all that good kind of jazz. Love y'all.
Okay guys, I'm heading out, period. Don't mind the trash, but yeah, heading out. Let's go to the airport. I'm going like super early, but I'm always thinking like the worst can happen, so let's go. Currently waiting for the shuttle and it's hot. No, seriously y'all, I am really waiting for the shuttle and it is actually hot outside. Like, and it's not like that hot like where the sun's just beaming. It's like a humid, sticky hot, like get me out of this heat hot, like a sauna, like a rotisserie chicken.
She just said to me,